So if you've got an Ultimaker 2, you can upgrade it to a Plus version with Ultimaker's kit. Or you can use E3D's custom-made kit with an all-metal V6 Hotend and a tightened extruder to upgrade the standard, plus and extended Ultimakers to an Ultimaker 2 E3D edition. So let's have a look at what you're getting. Up top, you'll find a nozzle kit, the tightened extruder, and the tool head with a pre-assembled V6. You'll also get a sample of E3D edge filament, a new wiring loom, and a bag with, most importantly, gummy bears, some heat shrink, the power cooling fan shrouds, a few fasteners, as well as a Bowden removal tool. In the Titan box, you'll get a new extruder motor, the extruder body, drive gear, and the idler lever, as well as a bag with screws and hex keys, which you can also use for the rest of the assembly, and the motor cable. In this metal box, you'll find the full range of nozzles for the V6. Before you start working on it, make sure your Ultimaker 2 is unplugged and cooled down, then slowly push the bed all the way downwards to give yourself a bit more room to work with. Start by removing both part cooling fans from the original printhead. Then remove the Bowden clip and the Bowden tube itself by pushing down on it with your fingers or the Bowden removal tool. We will be reusing the fans and their screws, as well as the long M3 screws that we will remove next. To completely remove the original printhead, pop out one end of the top rail while levering it off the back bearing block. Next, unplug the part cooling fans by pulling on the white plugs instead of the wires, then carefully screw the fans onto the new fan shrouds, orienting the wires towards the taller section of the shroud. Now remove the temporary screws or zip ties from the new printhead and take a look at how it fits together. For the next two steps, I've laid the Ultimaker 2 onto its right side. Start the assembly by pushing the black plate with the Hotend onto the bottom bearing, making sure the corner with the Hotend mount is pointing towards the front right-hand corner of the printer. Then grab the wires and connectors from the part cooling fans and Hotend fan and feed them through the center hole of the plate. Add the white, gray, and second black plate to trap the bearings, making sure to feed the wires through each plate. Loosely slide the original long M3 screws through the corner holes and connect the new wiring harness. The connectors only fit one way. Now we're going to start tightening up the printhead by adding a washer and an M3 nut to each screw, then tightening them while keeping the nuts from spinning with a wrench or some pliers. Then add another nut and a washer, positioning them about half an inch or 15 millimeters away from the end of the thread. Next, snap on the hot and cooling fan from towards the back of the printer, with the overhanging lip towards the top of the printhead. Then add the part cooling fan assemblies and secure them in place with another washer and a nut. Make these flush with the end of the thread, then tighten down the top nut. And we're almost done with the printhead. Now will be a good time to check that the silicone sock on the hot end is properly seated on the heater block and the nozzle's bore is centered on the opening. Tilt the Ultimaker 2 back into its upright position, push the new Bowden tube into the fitting as far as it will go, and secure it in place with the clips from the original assembly. And that's the printhead completed. Let's get your new Titan extruder installed. We'll start by removing the wire shroud with these two screws, and we'll unclip the Bowden tube like before and unscrew the original extruder. Support the motor with your hand inside the printer to keep it from falling onto the bed. We'll now add the new extruder block and secure it onto the new motor with this screw. Hold the block, screw, and Allen key with one hand, and then add the motor with the other and screw them together. Then add the drive gear, Bowden adapter, and filament guide. Complete the idler spring assembly by adding the nut and spring to the M4 screw, then mount the idler lever and snap the spring assembly in place. Then screw on the top. The shorter of the four M3 screws goes into the hole closest to the Bowden fitting. Check that the extruder lever operates smoothly, then install the remaining end of the Bowden tube into the Bowden fitting. For the last step, we'll wire everything into the Ultimaker 2's electronics. Holding the original extruder motor, lay the printer onto its left side, then remove the bottom electronics cover by removing these two screws, which are tightened into these nuts. Then remove the mainboard by undoing these four screws and, using a screwdriver to lift the tab if necessary, unplug the wires marked Temp 1, E1, Fan PWM, and Fan 5V. Press down on the orange spots to release the heater wires. Then pull out the original wiring and remove the extruder motor. You can now feed in the new wiring harness, tucking it in on the opposite side from the Titan's drive gear and behind its idler lever. Also connect the new extruder motor wire and we can start reconnecting everything to the mainboard. Push the two wires marked heater into the two terminals closest to the rear of the printer. After pulling the motor cable down into the compartment, plug it in at E1 with a red wire facing towards the other motor wires. Newer kits will come with a white connector instead of this black one. Connect the wire marked PT100 to temp1, part fan to fan PWM, and heatsink fan to the header marked 24V, making sure the black wire is oriented towards the edge of the board. Then slide the mainboard back into position, making sure not to get any wires caught, and reattach it with a screw in each corner. Then replace the electronics cover by lining up the tabs, pushing it in, and fixing it in place with these two nuts and black screws. Replace the wiring cover and screw it in. And you're done with the hardware conversion. Now will be a good time to open up those gummy bears for a snack, but we're not quite done yet. The last thing we need to do is to upgrade the firmware on your Ultimaker 2. Open up a version of the classic Cura 15.04 and select Machine, Install Custom Firmware, then select the hex file provided by E3D. When uploading is done, your Ultimaker 2 will restart, and after adjusting the build plate, you can start printing with your Ultimaker 2 E3D edition. Now add the E3D sticker and you're done. Happy printing! So I hope you found this guide helpful. If you did, I'd appreciate a thumbs up, and get subscribed if you want to see more guides, reviews and other 3D printing and making related videos. If you want to support this channel directly, check out my Patreon campaign. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.